Greetings of the day. I am Lakshman Jajodia, Assistant Professor, Department of Advanced Management Studies, GS College of Commerce, Vardhan. In the last couple of videos, we have discussed about certainty equivalence method, which is used for risk analysis in capital budgeting. It is considered more reliable and viable method because rather than adjusting discounting factors, it adjusts expected cash flows. That is why it is considered reliable for risk assessing. Now we will discuss about sensitivity analysis method, which is also known as what if method. In this method, the information is provided to how sensitive the expected project parameters are to the estimated errors. Project parameters can anything, discount rate, selling price, cash inflows. These are the expected project parameters which are need to be assessed with respect to the risk. As we all know, future is uncertain. A decision maker may always like to know the viability of the project if any of the expected parameter deviate from the expected outcome. In this method of sensitivity analysis, it basically has three assumptions. The very first assumption is of pessimistic, that is very strict approach in which we consider the worst outcome which can happen to a project. Second one is most likely, that is expected. In it, we consider what can be most likely to happen, that is expected one. Then the last assumption is optimistic, that is the best which can happen. The very positive way in which we think at least this much can be, which can be received with respect to a particular project. In this particular method, we will use discounting factor. Remember one thing, discounting factor can be categorized into two types. Number one, in which we have to take yearly approach. When the cash flows are different for each year, we have to multiply it by each year's discounting factor at that particular percentage. When the cash inflows are same for all the economic life of that particular project, then we can use PVIF, which is cumulative discounting factor for all the particular years. We will discuss the question. A Limited has two mutually exclusive projects from which we have to select one project, and they are provided following information, and we are required to calculate NPV for each possible outcome. Remember one thing, there are three possible outcomes, that is pessimistic, most likely and optimistic. We have to calculate for all three outcomes for the two projects, that is Q and R, for both the projects. We have been already provided with PVIF. As the cash inflows are same for 5 years, we have directly been given PVIF with the discounting rate of 16%. Cost of capital, we have to suggest which project is risky. We have to find out which project is risky from other. Remember one thing, question can be slightly deviated from the part of conclusion. I can even though ask, suggest which project is less risky, which project is more risky, like that. So coming to the statistical information, initial cash outlay for both the project is 6,50,000. Estimated cash flow inflows for 5 years, it means that it is equal for all 5 years. In pessimistic approach, it is 2 lakh for project Q, for project R it is 1 lakh, for most likely it is 2,50,000 for both the projects. In optimistic approach, it is 3,50,000 and 4,50,000. As we have been asked to assess the answer on the basis of NPV, we will start with the calculation of NPV. For that purpose, for particulars, we have possible outcomes. There are three possible outcomes: pessimistic, most likely and optimistic. We have write the three outcomes. Then we have to divide the remaining portion of the table into two equal parts, for project Q and for project R. We need four columns in it, for so that we can simply calculate in the most easiest manner. First of all would be cash inflows, which are already been provided in the question, that is 2,50,000 and 3,50,000. Discounting factor, which was 16%, we have directly taken the PVIF value of 3.274 for cumulative value for 5 years. You can refer to the Q cumulative PV table attached with the video. For this purpose, it is provided. Now we have just done a simple calculation of cash flows multiplied by discounting factor is equals to our present value. That is 2 lakh multiplied by 3.274 equals to 6,54,800. Likely for the second thing, we have again repeated the same calculation method. For most likely, 2,50,000 into 3.274 is equals to 8,18,500. And for optimistic, 3,50,000 into 3.274 equals to 11,45,900. This is our present value of cash inflows, but we have to compute the net present value, which came after deducting the cash outlay or cash outflow, which has been mentioned here. What was our cash outflow for that particular project? 6,50,000 minus, 6,54,800, that was our present value, minus 6,50,000. We have a positive net cash inflow of 4,800. That means 6,54,000 minus 6,50,000, that is 4,800. For most likely, 8,18,500 minus 6,50,000, 1,68,500. For optimistic approach, 11,45,900 minus 6,50,000, that is 4,95,900. Same thing we have repeated for project R. We have just done the one thing, 1 lakh into 3.274 equals to 3,27,400. 2,50,000 into 3.274 equals to 8,18,500. Lastly, 4,50,000 into 3.274 equals to 14,73,300. That is our present value. Again, for calculation of net present value, we have to deduct our investment, that is initial cash outlay, that was 6,50,000. In the pessimistic approach, our present value was 3,27,400, but our cash outflow was of 6,50,000. Hence, we have here negative net present value of 3,22,600. For most likely, we have 8,18,500, that is 1/2 present value, minus, for calculating NPV, we have deducted cash outlay from it, that is 6,50,000, and we have our answer of 1,68,500. For the last one, optimistic approach, our present value is 14,73,300 minus cash outlay, that is 6,50,000. We have our answer of 8,23,300. So we can suggest that we should accept project Q as it is less risky, and we have been asked suggest which project is risky. Definitely project R is risky as compared to project Q, because there is, in the case of project R, there is a chance of suffering the loss in the pessimistic approach, which cannot be seen in the case of project Q. Hence it is suggested that project R is risky. This is our conclusion, but in the practical scenario, the scene can be different. It depends which project to be choose according to the risk-taking capacity of the decision-maker. If suppose the decision-maker is of conservative approach, definitely he or she will choose project Q, because at any point of time, it has been seen that there is no chance of suffering the loss as all NPVs are positive. But if a decision-maker is not conservative and aggressive, he or she likes to take the risk so that they can have better returns and higher returns, they can definitely choose for project R, because as we can see, there is great chances of getting, if the optimistic approach is successful, higher returns. So it depends upon the risk appetite of decision maker whether to choose which project, but according to question, you will suggest that project R is risky as compared to project Q. Stay tuned. Thank you. In the next lecture, we will discuss about other things. Thank you.